physics. No, this ain't math. It's organic chemistry, man, and I hope I don't take a bath. This MO theory, I just don't get this thing. And now this guy's telling me that it's just like this guitar string. Oh man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Just look at ethylene, the bonding is pi. The homo's way down here, and the lumo's up high. The homo is bonding, it don't have a node, and the lumo's repulsive. Can I do this with my course load? Oh man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Two PAOs in, two pi MOs out. That's what ethylene is all about. I play this note here, it's just like the homo. But if I put in a node, I get the lumo. Oh man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Got three carbons in line, two, three, or four, electrons are fine. The R-bonding psi one is filled in the cation, but the homo's non-bonding in allyl anion. Oh man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Inside two and allyl, the node's on C2. You know it gets pretty lonely when there's no electron on you. Side two don't change the structure, the bonds don't change size. It's non-bonding, baby, and I can't empathize. Oh man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Well, the number of carbons in butadiene is 4. Occupied MOs, and on top of them there's 2 more. It's kind of peculiar in butadiene. All of the nodes fall in between. Whoa, man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Well, the homo has 1 node, the lumo has 2. Psi-2's antisymmetric with respect to C2. And this cycloaddition, now how does this go? You know what it is. It's homo-lumo. Whoa, man, I got the molecular orbital blues. Hey, you know what? Hey, it's not so confusing if you learn some rules. Woodward and Hoffman, those guys were no fools. Is it permitted? Is it 4N plus 2? Hey, I think I got it. I'm no longer blue. I think I'm over. Yes, I'm over my molecular orbital blues. No more blues. Bring on that organic chemistry. I got these MOs down. We'll just see how I do on the test.